But first up is a gentleman who has served as president and chief executive officer of Fennovoima since October 2014. In addition to his wide management experience, Mr. Hemminki has held numerous positions as of trust, either as chairman or member of the board of directors. And he's here to talk about the gateway to international markets with his song. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Toni Hemming.
All right. Thank you. That was a different song that I sent here, but thank you for the surprise. All right. My song was Beautiful Day, and it's based on the memories. I used to live in Oulu, and I remember many autumn days in Linnanmaa, where I was jogging around the Lake Kuivasjärvi, and I really enjoyed that time in Oulu. Let's take some exercise, not physical, but brain, so that we woke up after lunch. Let's show some hands that who has worked directly or indirectly with our project already in Pyhäjoki. Okay, so maybe 20%. Who has that in your mind? Whose company is planning to do that? Okay, couple more. All right, so I will try to illustrate and give picture that what is the future of the nuclear on my opinion at the moment, and where it is going to happen. And then I will talk a bit about our project and the status of the project, and ending the presentation on showing the couple of pictures from the site. Okay, this is having a bad day, so I will use these buttons instead. All right. In the Paris Climate Agreement, the goal is to stop global warming into the 2 degrees of warming up the atmosphere. And there are several different scenarios how to succeed on that. And the International Energy Agency, which is the most respected agency or the association doing the different estimations how the global energy production will evolve, has estimated that nuclear power output should be 2.5-fold compared to nowadays production, and when we are looking at 2014, if we want to succeed on stopping climate change, so restricting the global warming into the 2 degrees. That basically means, with more understandable explanation, that current nuclear production is 2,500 terawatt hours, so annually that amount of energy. 2040, it should be more than 6,000. Basically, it means that from today until 2040, in global level, there should be one Hanhikivi equivalent power plant started up per month. In Finland or in Europe, it doesn't feel like that. There is a lack of discussion about nuclear because there are European countries like Germany that says that we want to abandon the production. But if we looked at globally, the scenario and the understanding in the global level is that there is a huge market for the new built nuclear. And let's talk about it. There is a quite easy answer if somebody asks that why. This is the CO2 emissions tons per gigawatt hours produced, but comparison between the different means of production. For example, coal, more than 800 tons of CO2 per gigawatt hours produced, compared to nuclear, close to zero. We are competing with the hydroelectric and wind. So therefore, we are there in the toolbox of solutions when the climate change is being battled against. But like I said, the discussion not really very active in Europe. And you can see it from the next slide or next picture. Globally, we are in the high peak of the production of the new capacity. Since 25 years, there is the highest level of constructions ongoing. And you can see from the picture that it's done mostly in eastern side of the globe. So in China. China is leading the game. There are also Western countries like US. For your benefit, if you want to study the map a little bit more closely, I will leave this in the presentation, but you can see the numbers that, for example, in Asia, between 2015 and 16, the change was 46 terawatt hours. Compared to us, we will produce 9 terawatt hours. So there is a huge market. So if you think us as a gateway to the nuclear business, there are two issues that I want to talk today. Have a long-term view. We will be here for over the 60 years of our production. And have a global view, because market happens to be at the moment in many other countries. And not maybe at the moment in Europe. I strongly believe that it will come back to Europe as well, because climate change is so problematic issue, and there is no clear solutions without utilizing all the possible technologies that we have, including the nuclear. Had an interesting discussion heard an interesting discussion on Monday when James Hansen, who is the leading, he's basically the father of the global warming, the scientist who first realized with his team that how the global warming works and what is the effect of the climate change. He was promoting in the Nordic Business Forum on Monday that the nuclear is a solution. So if we focus a little bit outside Europe, we can see quite a lot of discussion where there are environmental movements promoting nuclear. In US, in some states, there are demonstrations. So people are demonstrating their opinions in the streets against closing down the nuclear power plants. There is a good TED talk, for example, for that there are studies in California where they have closed down the nuclear power, coal and gas come instead. So the CO2 goes up. All right, but that's the start. If there still is somebody in this region who doesn't know us, I will show a couple of numbers. Not going to go through all the issues that who we are, but we are going to build a power plant to Pyhäjoki. It's based on the Rosatom VVER technology. It's a 3+ generation of technology, meaning that it takes into account and it includes all the safety features are required nowadays after Fukushima. For example, the plant can survive and be there without additional external electricity or energy supply or water supply for 72 hours. We are the biggest project in Finland. The size of the investment from the beginning until the plant is up and running, including the financing cost during the construction period, is about 7 billion euros. And the VTT has estimated that roughly about 2 billion will be domestic, depending how the domestic companies, i.e. EU, will manage the competition. We have been growing quite fast and well in Fennovoima. I joined the company on October 2014. We were about 90 persons at that time. Today number exactly is 341. So about 350 people now working, mainly in Helsinki office, roughly about 30 persons in Pyhäjoki. Work will move to Pyhäjoki from Helsinki office during the years 19 and 20. Then, the project will last about 10 years, from the beginning of signing the contract until the plant is in the commercial operations. It has different phases. Now we are in the licensing, so the design and infrastructure phases. So we are doing the preparatory work at site, building the secondary buildings, the office buildings and training buildings, etc. I will show some pictures later on. But the main work that we are doing is that we are going through the power plant design and making sure as an owner and the customer of Rosatom that the design fulfills the Finnish safety requirements. 2 weeks ago, roughly about 2 weeks ago, we came out and published our opinion that we felt and our view about the schedule for the construction licenses that we will gain that during 2019, not as we have previously estimated 2018. And that is where we connect the information that we get from the supplier and the discussion that we have with the Finnish authorities, basically looking at how long does it take to take all the Finnish requirements into account in documenting the design that there is. We have went through the basic technical solutions and haven't been touching them too much. There are some obvious changes that will be done. For example, in Europe, the nuclear power plant nowadays needs to hold against the crash of the full-size commercial airplane. In other countries, it might be a smaller plane. So there are obvious changes that needs to be done. But main technical solutions we have went through, and they are in a good order, and we are pleased with the technology. What we are doing at the moment is going through with the supplier the phase where we are changing the documentation of the technology so that it fulfills the Finnish requirements. And then after 2019, we will move to the construction phase. Detailed design, of course, will be done during that phase as well. And we have a plan that the fuel will be at site 22-23, and then the commercial operations, according to current plans, will start 2024. But we are, during this autumn, discussing with the supplier about how they will update the schedule. Spent fuel, i.e. nuclear waste, is also, time to time, it's a hot topic in the Finnish media. In our case, we will start disposal, so storing the spent fuel after 75 years. So first time when we start that disposal of the spent fuel, that's 2090s. I hope that my daughter lives during those years, most certainly or most likely I don't. I'm trying to say that regardless of the discussion that there is time to time, there is quite a lot of time for us to make the studies. And we are doing them with a couple of principles: safety, technology, and economical things first, and then selection of the places, etc. All right. I will leave this for your benefit and further studies to the material, but I will illustrate the fundamental picture where we are with the supply chain. The total delivery or the full delivery for us comes from the RAUS project, which is a subsidiary of Rosatom. Then how the different components are formed, we can conclude that the reactor and the equipment and the design regarding the reactor comes from the subsidies of Rosatom. Here we can see the Atom Enerkomash, who is typically the production unit for the Rosatom deliveries. However, the turbine comes from GE Steam Power, so the formal Alstom technology. So it's a Western technology based on the French production. And now, during the June, we published that the Rolls-Royce and Schneider were selected as a preferred supplier for the safety automation and the operational automations. So quite typical way of procuring technologies from the Finnish perspectives. Core of the technology where the Rosatom has the full and best knowledge, nuclear island, comes from their production facilities, and then supporting technologies like turbine generator comes from the different sources, and the automation comes also from the different sources. Rolls-Royce, for example, is at the moment renewing the Loviisa nuclear power plant automation, so they have very good knowledge about the finish processes and how you should, for example, describe the designs in Finland. Our reference plant is going to be commissioned next year, and that's a great benefit for us. That's a Sosnovyi Leningradskaya 2 power plant near us, so we can take a train and maybe just 1.5 hour car drive after that, and voila, we have our daughter plant in there, and they are now testing the plant. We can utilize all that knowledge while designing our and looking through our design documentation. So that's a good benefit that typically those reference plants can be in the other side of the world, for example. We are sending people on monthly basis to follow the test runs of the Leningradskaya 2 plant nowadays. All right, then something about our thinking, our requirements, if you want to be a supplier, and how we think that it benefits on developing your business. While visiting Oulu, time to time, or quite many times, I have a question that, do I really have to have a quality management system, or do I really need to certify it if I really do the good quality anyway? And in most of the cases, answer is yes. We are working in the nuclear business, so everything what we do needs to be in very high quality. The more close you go to the nuclear part of the power plant, the better quality and more complete quality management systems you need to have. So instead of trying to avoid it, maybe utilize us as a tool to develop your company capabilities when it comes to quality management, or occupational safety that was mentioned in the silver mining presentation. As an example for us, we have now went through 9 months without an accidents. I personally go through all the accidents what we have, and I personally also go through all the corrective actions that we have for the accidents. That shows a kind of commitment, not only to the quality, but the safety practices on more broad level. We have, as you could see from the picture from the supply chain, we have a multicultural project. Within those 350 Fennovoima employees, we have 20 different nationalities. So it's very good to have a understanding about the different cultures and being able to adapt to the different cultures when negotiating and when working together. And when having the right attitude in there, I think it's very rewarding. Because typically when there are different cultures, there are maybe different ways of looking issues, and then thereafter the operations also developed further. The contracts are made not only for Finnish companies, but for the global competition in the supply chain. And there is our supplier RAS project and the main contractor Titan 2 in the exhibition room, and you can have a more detailed discussion about the contracts. But I believe that naturally they are looking for the global competition. So the contracts, billing and payment practices, they might feel, and time to time I also share the opinion that they are quite heavy, but we have a supplier, they have selected the way so that they can have the competitions on a global level. So be prepared for that. I personally think that if you are looking to go into that global market where I described that there's a quite big business there. We are very good stepping down to that because we are from the, let's say, most strict and toughest end. The Finnish authority has the highest requirements when it comes to the quality management systems or configuration management or way we practice any business that we have. So when you work with us or with Hanhikivi project, then you are well prepared to work in any other country or in any other project. All right, now I was shown 5 minutes and I think I'm in the middle of my presentation. All right. When you are interested about being a subcontractor, I know that this practice might be a bit different than it typically is in Finland, but it's important to go to the web page and register as a potential supplier so that we will get you into our portfolio when we look to suppliers, and also Titan 2 will, and most importantly, if you want to be on Hanhikivi construction site, Titan 2 will get you into the portfolio. And as I explained, they are here. If you have any question regarding the how this is done in practice, please let's have that discussion. All right. I will show a couple of pictures that what we are doing, but to remind you that before the actual construction of the power plant will start, we will invest about 400 to 500 million to prepare the construction site. So there is quite a lot of business already before the actual construction. Here is the list of issues that will be done. So it's secondary buildings and earthworks. I will leave it to the presentation so you can look it. I still can state proudly that we are, according to my understanding, most Finnish construction site in Finland. We have a site register where all the people who get to have a license to go into the site gate is registered. You need to go through the safety trainings and the trainings how you operate at that site. We have now approved a little bit more than 2,000 workers, where out of about 80 to 90% are Finns still. So good start. I'm sure that the supplier is utilizing quite a lot of Finnish companies because it's wise. You learn the Finnish way and you build the right way of working. Daily volume at the moment, I think that the high peak was last week or this week, 350 workers at the site at one time. Then some buildings that we have already built or that are under design. This is a training building, was taken into use last year before Christmas. It's a building where we plan to have about 26,000 people to be trained prior or before they get a permit to go to the from the site gates. Wooden construction, those who know me, I come from the steel industry, so I'm trying to get used to it. I think it's a beautiful building and it has been also getting some wood construction awards and recognitions from the design. Security gate building, that's a permanent security gate building that there will be, was concluded during August. Now we are refurbishing it. It will be taken into use later this year. This is our scope of work. Here is a picture about temporary housing that is done by Titan 2 with the help of Lehto Group, being built on this sort of modular basis like Lego blocks. I don't know, do you know, Michael, how many houses we already have?
Four.
Four, okay. Yeah. And here is the picture about where the actual plant will be. Do we have a laser here? No, we don't. But looking from this, Okay, it's a little bit difficult to explain, but here is the pit for the reactor plant and also the turbine plant. It's now on the -2 meters, and we will go forward after we have made sure that the layout fulfills the rest of the layout fulfills the Finnish requirements. All right, managed to finish on time.
Thank you.
Thanks.